كنوزي كان ستارت. ستارت
Good morning, grade 11.
Thank you. This is the third session of revision, اللي هي the five themes of geography. If you all remember the five themes of geography, you will know that they are movement, region, location, place, and human environment interaction. What is the definition of the five themes of geography? They are five categories or divisions that scientists use to study Earth's features or characteristics. So we divide Earth's features or characteristics into five categories or five divisions. The first one is movement. When I say movement, I am talking about the way things move or what are the things that move all over the Earth. Movement explores where different resources are located, the people that uses them, and how they're transported all over the Earth. What are the things that we have, whether they are resources, whether they are people, whether they are ideas, where are they located? Exactly, where is the location? And how do they move? This is the first idea, which is movement, you know, the movement of resources and people. What moves? When we say movement, what moves? What movement of what? One, people and goods. Two, information. And three, ideas. These are the three things that can move all around the world from one place to another. Okay, how do they move? These are the side bullet points. How do people and goods move? They move by trucks, cars, planes, trains, buses, boats, or in other words, the transportation methods. Information, how does information move or how does it get transported from one part of the world to the other? Through telephones, computers, or actual mails, postal mail services, letters, or packages. Finally, the third thing that moves around the world is an idea. How do ideas move? These ideas usually are in the form of trends or new things that show up in one part of the world and then the rest of the world starts copying it. How do ideas move? Through magazines, books, radio, and television. So the first category or the first section of Earth's features, which is movement. Do you have any questions concerning that?
No.
When I say, what are the things that move around the world? Who can answer?
Around, يعني,
what are the
no,
things that
space
move?
Or,
we never mentioned space. We're talking about all over Earth's surface. There are things that move. What are they? What moves?
People and goods.
Yes.
Information.
Yes.
Ideas.
Okay, thank you. That was Tadrus, right?
Yes.
Okay, so people, goods, information, and ideas. How do they move other than Tadrus?
By trucks, cars, trains, boats, planes.
What else?
Huh?
What else other than transportation methods? يعني trucks, planes,
computers,
computers, other than cool
telephones,
easy.
Miss Mena, I got the attendance.
Yes, I did.
طب أنا لسه داخلة دلوقتي.
I just noticed. Yes.
Too late.
Miss حسن رحيم الشينج اللي عنده مشكلة في النت.
Okay.
إن شاء الله.
So. حسن. Back to the question. Kunuz said one method of moving or movement, which is the transportation method that is concerned with goods and people. What else? How do things move? Or how does movement happen? Can you raise your voice, Haya? Magazines and radios. Do you remember what moves through magazines and radio?
Any ideas?
Yes, ideas. Excellent. And the third part, what is the third thing that can move and how does it move? Jenna. Garayki.
Yes, miss.
Yes, yeah, miss. What's the third thing that moves?
Computers, mails, and
telephones. Yeah, computers اللي moves. They move what?
And they move information.
They move information. Thank you. So information moves through computers, mails, and electronics. Okay. Telephone. Second part is region. If you take a look at this picture, you will find that this map is divided into three colors: yellow, orange, and green. The shaded part, or the color, is a section called a region. It's a section of the land that shares similar characteristics. We divide the place into regions. A region is a section or a part or a division that shares similar characteristics. What are these characteristics, or how do we divide things based on regions? It can be similar climate. It can be similar location, like for example, these countries are in the North Pole or in the Northern Hemisphere. It can be similar languages and culture, like when you, for example, say the Far East or the Middle East or Europe. These are a group of countries that share the same language and culture. So, do you understand what's a region?
Yes.
It's a section of Earth that is divided because it shares similar characteristics. It can be two or three countries. It can be a whole part or area that is bigger than that. Okay, location. Where is something? When I ask you, tell me where is the location, for example, of your house? How do you answer back?
بقول street.
يعني نقول مثلا north of كذا near كذا.
You will say near مثلا this pharmacy, or you will say it's on this street, right? Or you will say it's above this restaurant. So when you tell me the location of the house, you're saying the location of the house compared to other places, compared to other shops, compared to other stores, compared to other pharmacies. So you're saying the place, but comparing it, you have to mention something else. This is one type, which is called relative location. How else can you tell me the location of your house?
El GPS.
Excellent. You send your location through the GPS. The GPS will not tell me it's on this street or you go after this traffic light, take a U-turn, okay? It will tell me an exact location of cardinal directions, north, south, east, and west with the degrees. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, do you have any questions concerning the types of location?
No.
Okay. This is the same thing. Place. Anyone knows the difference between place and location?
ايوه بالنسبه كل الكاركترستكس بتاعتنا.
What's the difference between read? You have place in front of you. Read and tell me how is it different than location.
عشان place بتقول الكاركترستكس بتاعت المكان.
ازاي؟
يعني traits of qualities.
يعني مش هي
ممكن يبقى ريستورانت مثلا تقول مثلا
يا بليس
بليس ده
يا بليس
one by one case
يلا جمال لك انه هيقول
عبد الرحمن you were one of them
ايه
you were one of them you were going to answer so answer
يعني البليس ده بيكون يعني كل بليس ليه يوما يعني في ناس مختلفين عن البليس التاني. يعني ليه كاركترستيك، كل بليس ليه كاركترستيك، انما اللوكيشن دي
how is place different than region what you're saying is region.
والله ما خلاص
مثلا البليس فيمس بحاجة معينة عشان كده بيجاب بيها
close
يعني مثلا ريستورانت ده احمر مثلا حاجات كده.
طب you're talking okay some of you were close when we say when we compare place to region they're the same each talks about a place with similar characteristics whether they are human characteristics or physical so whoever said this answer was partially correct the mistake that you did is you did not say what is the difference a place is smaller than a region So when, for example, you go to the Middle East or the Far East or Europe, this is a region. It's a very big place consisting of more than one country of probably different languages or different climates. Okay? But a place, for example, when you go and you say a college or a mall, this is a place that you go to for certain characteristics, human characteristics, entertainment, for example. You're not going there to see some physical features. So the difference between region and place is that region is the big part. Place is smaller. It shares, yes, similar characteristics. All people go to mall for fun. No one goes, for example, to study, or no one goes to learn something new. No one goes, for example, to attend a wedding in a mall. They have certain characteristics. And finally, a location is a spot. It's an exact spot, an exact space that does not share anything similar with the regions around it. Okay? Grade 11.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So if I ask you to differentiate between location, place, and region, can you do that?
Yes.
Finally, human environment interaction. This is how people interact with the environment. We interact in three different ways. We depend on the environment for water and soil. We change the environment when we start building houses and roads. And we adapt to the environment. If it's a desert area, so we build houses that can stand the heat, we install air conditions. If it's a very cold area, we install heaters instead. We have roads that can stand the pressure of the snow. So we adapt to the environment. So what are the three ways that we interact with the environment or the surrounding? One, we depend. Two, we modify. And three, we adapt. Do you have any questions?
Thank you.